I should have hit my knees and prayed for better ways. He play at the red light, he'll catch a red light. Promise, baby, if your head right, then I'm the head knight. I went broke, I got my bread right, I got my bread right. I went broke, I got my bread right, got my bread right. Brr.
My name is Rod Wave. I'm from St. Petersburg, Florida, and I create music.
I'm Nana. This is my grandson, my second to oldest grandson. And we've been here in this house for over 25 years. Rodarius, Booby, Nuna. They call him Nat, whatever. But I call him Booby. You know, but they tell me, my niece that live in Atlanta, Quanice say that some of the people done heard his CDs in Atlanta and they love him. The first CD he made is two songs on the CD that I really do like, and it's Heartbreak Hotel, and I like Mama Said, I think too much.
It be over before it even begun. I catch feelings, feel attaching, then I run. I don't wanna leave, but I can't stay. I know it's hard dealing with a heart that you didn't break.
My mama, she stayed around the corner, my daddy stayed out the street.
Okay.
I always stayed out the street. The house I lived in when I was made down there, and then I was raised down there.
Steal your heart and dissolve it, baby. I don't wanna meet your mom and father, baby, because we ain't going no farther, baby. Yeah, yeah.
How did you first get into music?
Shit, my like fifth grade, I wasn't really into the music shit. My big brother was into that shit. You feel me? But he found I could sing, you know what I'm saying, just chilling around the house. So, like, he used to force me to sit down and sing and shit, like. Like, bro, just sing this for me. Let me see how this sound.
Yeah.
No. Say this, you know what I'm saying? So, and then once my daddy went to prison, we got separated. I just used to be in the habit of just coming home from school, doing it.
Yeah.
In school, writing it. So it just came, you know what I'm saying? Like,
right.
Fifth grade from now. I still be in the habit of just, I need to make a song today. You know what I'm saying? Or I feel like making a song today.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Or I go through some shit and be like, yeah, damn, that should be a raw ass song. You know what I'm saying?
What does your music represent?
Everyday life of what I go through, you know what I'm saying? People who got shit in common with me go through, you know, some shit I've seen, shit I've been through, how I be feeling. You know what I'm saying? It's no perpetration, you know what I'm saying? It just be how I be feeling or what I be going through or how I feel. You know what I'm saying? I'm not a talker, you know what I'm saying? I don't know how to talk to people. I don't know how to express myself. But whenever I have shit on my chest, I just, you know what I'm saying, ball that shit up. So with music, I could just hit a beat and just, that's how I talk to people, you know what I'm saying, about certain situations, how I break down my story, how I be feeling, I put that shit on wax, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I always made the music, but I never recorded, like in middle school and shit, mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And even when my first song that I ever put out, I didn't put it out, you know what I'm saying? My homeboy, he was like, bro, this shit sound good, you know what I'm saying? Maybe if we go to a real studio, it'd be better, but mm-hmm. This shit good. I know niggas blowing up with shit way worse than this, you know what I'm saying? Just let people hear it. I was like, listen, you do whatever you want. You want to let people hear it, go ahead. But you know what I'm saying? He put it out for me.
Yeah.
And he had like 3-4 songs that we had did. He just put them bitches out one by one. And people was like, yo, that shit funkin', bro.
Ass kissing, act different, I go missing like my last bitches. Till I die, I'ma grind with a point to prove. Fat fly nigga floating in an outer coupe. It's all your lie, nigga, when you said that ain't the truth. You know you lie when you told them that ain't the truth.
When it come on, no bass at all, like, right?
It's all piano keys.
All piano keys, like, I don't know which one is bass, but
I'm more comfortable now. Like right now, I could just bust out singing, you know what I'm saying? But back then, I couldn't do that. I had to be in a secluded area, you know what I'm saying? In a secluded spot with nobody really paying attention.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, that's why when I first started, my music didn't really have no face to it because I ain't want it like that. I didn't want nobody. I was still shy, you know what I'm saying?
So you're kind of getting used to that, getting over that?
Yeah, it's been a little minute, you know what I'm saying, going on stage. We in other cities and, you know what I'm saying, motherfuckers fucking with me. You know what I'm saying? That kind of boosts a nigga confidence. Yeah. Like, it don't blow up a nigga head, but it boosts a nigga confidence because I never been like the nigga who want attention. I never been like that, you know what I'm saying? I never been like, you know what I'm saying, like a clown or no shit. I always just been laid back, chilling, you know what I'm saying? I never been in the way, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, for sure.
So now that I'm in a music business where you have to be in the way, you know what I'm saying, it kind of threw me for a loop. I had to change a lot of shit that I do, you know what I'm saying? Like, I never had an Instagram until I started making music. I never had a Facebook. You know, I had one, but I wasn't, like, posting and shit like that.
Right.
You feel me?
What's the kind of biggest, like, live show that you performed?
Janet's Live with Kodak Black. Man, that shit was a whole nother level, you know what I'm saying? That shit was inspiration to see a nigga come from what I come from, you know what I'm saying, in a different form, you know what I'm saying? Can have all these races and these genders and all kind of shit in one spot, you know what I'm saying, for you. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. To hear your music, you know what I'm saying? Your music brought in a whole nother city, you know what I'm saying? Brought all these people together. And they listening to your story, they listening to your message, and they feel it and they understand it and they want to know more about it. That shit kind of inspired me to go further because that's all I ever wanted, was to be heard, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I just never had it in me to just get in front of a bitch and hear my story, you know what I'm saying? That was kind of like my way to just sneak it in there, like I just drop a song and whoever hear it, yeah. You know what I'm saying? One thing about my music, bro, when a person hear it, you know what I'm saying, if they like it, it's because they feel it. You know what I'm saying? It's not because, oh, this shit got a nice beat. You know what I'm saying? It ain't because, what the fuck, this shit ain't clickbait. You know what I'm saying? It ain't because it's on World Star. Because I never even been on that shit, but if a nigga listening to my shit, he listening to my shit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So I know in 10 years, I'm going to have a whole lot of listeners and core fans that I could book a motherfucking arena with 50,000 people in that bitch, like Drake or some shit. You know what I'm saying? Because Drake music, like, you can feel that shit what he be talking about. You know what I'm saying? Even if it's about some lovey-dovey shit, you still, even if you never been through it, you still can, like, understand a little bit.
You can relate to it. How do you feel about where you are right now in your life and in your music career?
Man, I don't give a fuck nobody say. I'm happy because once upon a time, I was doing some whole other shit. You know what I'm saying? I was taking people's shit. I would wake up in the morning with $20 in my pocket, like, bitch, I got to go do something. You know what I'm saying? I'll come take your shit. You know what I'm saying? Burglary.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Nigga do anything for that cheese, man. It's just the way of the city, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's not a trend or no shit, but when you see these niggas coming through, you know what I'm saying? You can see these niggas pulling back. You see these niggas spreading, you know what I'm saying? It's like, man, I want to be straight too.
Yeah.
You feel me? But this is what I'm from, you know what I'm saying? I ain't come from the outskirts of the city like some of them niggas way out the north side and come here and try to thug. Yeah. But y'all was raised over here, you know what I'm saying? I grew up with these niggas.
Where I come from, it ain't safe to believe. Where I come from, they ain't chasing a dream. Where I come from, it ain't safe to believe. They jump straight off the porch and then straight in the streets. Goddamn, heard you keep your glizzy in your pants. Goddamn, I heard you have plans to be the man. Goddamn, I heard you in love with them bands. Goddamn, hope you know that you don't stand a chance. Whoa.
If you could collab with any artists, like, who would you want to work with right now?
I mean, like I said, like, my music, I don't do it because it sounds, you know what I'm saying? I don't do it because it funk. I don't do it because the beat nice. I do it because I be going through shit, you know what I'm saying? So if I was ever to collab with somebody, it would be because I heard his music. And because I'm a music head first, you know what I'm saying? I always listen to all kind of music. Mm-hmm. So it was because I heard your music. And it kind of simulate what I be going through, you know what I'm saying? So I feel like me and you kind of together. Our struggles to be on the same song, or our everyday life to be on the show. Mm. I don't just collab with a bitch because they hot, you know what I'm saying? I don't give a fuck nobody say, you got some old party ass shaking shit. I ain't really trying to do no song with you for real because we ain't got shit in common, for real.
Yeah.
Or you might got a nigga who might saying something, nigga, I'll pull up on your street and shoot you in the head, shit. I ain't really fucking with that, you know what I'm saying? I don't really, not because I ain't on that, but I'm trying to spread another message, you know what I'm saying? These little niggas catching elbows out here, you know what I'm saying? They losing their life, you know what I'm saying? Mama losing their kids and shit, so I'm on a platform now to where if I say some shit, a lot of motherfuckers gonna hear it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So you, like, even if I say some shit, right, yeah, I got a chance to change shit, why would I be? You know what I'm saying? So I ain't knocking nobody's shit. I wouldn't want to get on the song with you because we in two different lanes right now.
Yeah.
I'ma push your shit, I'ma help you. If a nigga ask me about you, I'ma tell him good shit about you. You know what I'm saying? But man, you in two different lanes, you know what I'm saying? I'm on some whole other shit right now. City of St. Petersburg is me, you know what I'm saying? Everything that I am, it's the reason, you know what I'm saying? Other than my mom and them, it's the reason, you know what I'm saying? I done went to war with these niggas. I done went to school with these niggas. I done been to JDC with these niggas is me. We all, you know what I'm saying? That's why I can come to shit like this and they, you know what I'm saying? Because we each other, you know what I'm saying? I'm you, me. We done been through the same shit. I'm just making music now. You know what I'm saying? This city mean a lot to me, bro, because I wouldn't be up on game how I am shit, you know what I'm saying? Without the city, you know what I'm saying? I'd be, you know what I'm saying? This city mean a lot to me, bro. Like, my family, this is where I was raised at. I've never been nowhere else.